الدين. هلا شو هلا شو كانت كهرباء الدولة ولا شو؟ Now we have to check the generators. Generators here.
Shihad Shihimi er på en noget nær umulig opgave. Som driftschef på Beiruts største offentlige hospital kæmper han med daglige strømsvigt og mangel på stort set alt.
You see many problems. What can I do? I have to fight every day.
Libanons sundhedsvæsen, som engang var Mellemøstens bedste, lider under den dybe økonomiske krise, som landet lige nu befinder sig i.
The last ampoule available in the hospital. But as the worker said, you know, the mortality and the morbidity is affected now. And this is a high alert.
Vi har besøgt Rafik Hariri Universitetshospital og fulgt to af medarbejderne på det, de kalder en helt almindelig arbejdsdag.
So now I have to prepare coffee. I am lucky because I have solar system. I save now. I save gas. For that, I start to make the water in the kettle because from the sun. So I save the gas from here. You see, you have to manage yourself.
For bare få år siden tilhørte Shihad Shihimi og hans familie den øvre middelklasse i Libanon, men nu skal de spare på selv de mest basale ting.
It's very difficult. I work and my wife at the same time work. My son, my daughter, we are four now work in the house. Before it was very good, but now it is very bad. Yani, how can I explain it? Yani, you are trying to save money every day. Now they are talking about the crisis. No. This from the hospital. I have to follow up everything from my house. Every 10 minutes problems. I have problems every hours. I have to make one call just 1 minute, please. Hey, sabah Ali, kifak? شو الوضع؟ هن لازم يشتغلوا كل شيء صح. هن لازم يضبطوه. There is no electricity. I have to. I buy this car. I buy this car 4 years ago, before the inflation. $2,000, because I am lucky. Now I cannot buy any car. Cannot buy anything. If you have problem in one wheel, for example, or in anything in the car, you have to pay fresh dollar. Fresh dollar, that means you spend your salary only in in one problem.
Beirut var engang kendt som Mellemøstens Paris. Op gennem 60'erne og 70'erne rejste det europæiske jetset til byen for at slå sig løs. En smeltedigel af en by, der kunne tilbyde det hele. Men i 1975 bryder borgerkrigen ud og splitter landet. Omkring 150.000 er mister livet. Fra 2011 sender krigen i nabolandet Syrien over 1 million flygtninge ind over grænserne. Det lægger hårdt pres på Libanon med blot 5 millioner indbyggere. I dag er det libaneserne selv, der flygter på grund af en dyb økonomisk krise, der for alvor begyndte i 2019 efter mange år med korrupte politikere og dårlig ledelse af landet.